Hey guys, Sanjay here, back with another video. The dynamic bias lighting which I am showing off right now is made possible by an application called Hyperion. There are many ways to use this application, but in this video I will focus on how I use this application on Windows PC with an Arduino Uno and a compatible LED strip. As I said earlier, possibilities are endless. You can use this application with a Raspberry Pi and an USB capture hardware with any compatible LED strip you like. For this, I have 5 meter WS2812B LED strip, few solderless joints for connecting the sliced strips together, an Arduino Uno board. Any Arduino should work as long as it has a PWM output, a Windows PC, and an 5-volt power supply with required current for powering the LEDs. In my case, for the power supply, I went with an old ATX power supply. I just shorted the power good to the ground, that is a green wire to a black wire in the 24-pin connector, which turns on the power supply. Basically, what it does is making the ATX power supply to believe that is connected to a motherboard and the motherboard is asking to turn on and supply power. In some modern power supplies, you need to connect a resistor in parallel with the 5-volt lane, because the modern power supply are intelligent and it knows when to power on the motherboard and when to shut it off. It is a protection circuit implemented on modern power supplies. For those power supplies, I will link the proper guide in the description below. You can make use of it. Now the power is sorted out, then we can install some programs on our PC. First, we need to install the Arduino software from the Arduino site. I have provided the link in the description below. You can use that to download this application. And after that, go ahead and install it. Then you can launch the Arduino IDE once it is installed. And this is the code we are going to use. I will come back to this later. Now you can connect the Arduino to the PC. You can see the Arduino's connected port by clicking on the tools and then going to the port and followed by the port name and the board name. You can select something similar to this. This will look different on your Windows PC. I forgot to film this, so I need to add it while I'm editing in a Linux machine. I have plans to create more open source software videos going forward. If you are interested, subscribe to the channel. Hope you enjoy those videos too. Okay, back to the IDE. Now we need to add a library called FastLED, which is necessary for the code to run properly. To do that, click on Tools, then go to Manage Libraries, then search for FastLED and click on the first row of the search results, which is basically the FastLED library. Now just click on the install button, which will eventually install the library needed for this code to run. For the code, I have given the link in the description. You can go in there and just copy this code and paste it over here. Then we need to add some modifications to the code to specify the number of LEDs we are going to use. First of all, change the number of LEDs which you are going to use. In my case, it is 106. Probably most of the Arduino have the pin number 6 as a PWM pin. If you have an older Arduino, it may not have the pin number 6 as PWM, so you can choose pin number 13 or something similar. After that, you can compile the program and then upload it to your respective Arduino board. This is the right time to connect the LED strip, Arduino, and the power. I'm using pin 6, so I have connected the pin 6 to the signal pin in the LED strip. Then I have connected the ground to the ground of the power supply and the LED strip. Finally, connect the 5-volt to the LED strip. And if you like to power the LED, and if you like to power the Arduino with the same power supply, then connect the 5-volt to the Arduino too. Basically, you can connect it on the 5-volt pin, which is labeled in the Arduino. Now we can keep the Arduino aside along with the LED strips, and we need to install some programs in our PC. There are two programs we need to install. One is called Hyperion, which gives the data to the Arduino connected to our computer. Other is the DirectX 11 capture software called Hyperion Screen Capture, which streams the video to a specific port in the Hyperion server, which streams the video to the Hyperion. It may need some dependencies from Microsoft, so install those if required. I have given links for the respective software GitHub release pages in the description below. Just download them and install them to your machine. After the installation is done for the Hyperion and the Hyperion Capture software, now let's go ahead and right click on the Hyperion configuration, which is in the system tray. When you right click on the Hyperion logo, it will show an option called settings. Click on that. It will open the default browser. There you can see the welcome page. Now click on the wrench icon on the top right corner and navigate to the settings level. Then change the settings level to expert in the drop down and save it. Then click on the configuration tab and go to LED hardware selection. Under LED controller, change the type to ADA light, then specify the number of LEDs. Now move over to the LED layout tab and specify the number of LEDs on all sides. I have 34 on the top and bottom, 19 on either sides. I have also reversed the order because I am an idiot. I'm connecting everything in the reverse order, so I used the checkbox to reverse the order. To find the input position, you can just give the position of the LED. Basically, you can do that by trial and error. First, give 0, it will show some LED numbers. It is showing a number on the place of my LED, starting LED. So, just give that number. Basically, it will take us to the correct point. Then, it is almost done now. Go to the Capture Hardware menu under Configuration and uncheck the Enable Platform Capture. That's it, Hyperion is ready. Once you open the Hyperion screen capture, you can just change the IP address for your local machine which hosts the server. That is 127.0.0.1:19400. It will work for everyone, assuming you have installed the Hyperion screen capture software on the same machine. Now for auto starting on, every time you turn on your machine, you need to add the Hyperion screen capture in. For that, hold down the Windows key plus R, then you can type shell colon startup. Now copy and paste the desktop shortcut which is created by the installation and paste it into this opened folder. Now do a reboot. If you have given every parameters right and if you connected everything right, it should work. If it is not, go ahead and troubleshoot it. There is an awesome community for us to help with our problems. I have given the forum link in the description below. Every software is not a perfect software, so everything has its own problem. The problem I am facing with my setup is that if my PC sleeps, the screen capture and the Hyperion crashes. I haven't found any solution yet. If you have any solution, please let me know in the comment section below. And hope you guys enjoyed this video. If so, smash the like button and hit the subscribe button. Wish you a great luck for setting up the BIOS lighting for your setup. And thanks for watching.